For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet until her vindication shines forth like the dawn and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after
coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet. The word of the Lord.
About 10 years ago, says, I know what I'll do. I'll return to my father. I'll present myself as a slave. And where is it that God comes to meet us? But in that lowest place, you know, among the animals, among that place where they feed. But when the prodigal son returns to his father to say, hey, I'm ready to become a slave. I no longer deserve to be called your son. What does the father do? He stops him. He stops him because his sonship, his childhood, it is not something that of his that he can lose. It's the father who bestows it. And when the father bestows that gift, he never takes it back. We might try to mar it by sin. We might try to cloud it. But when the father, when he gives, he gives definitively. He gives because he knows what we're worth. He knows what we're meant to be. And he knows that we need the encouragement not to always come back to him, to always turn back to him. And so, this Christmas, as we celebrate this joyous occasion, as we spend time with those who we love, that we remember the one who has first loved us. We remember the one who called us into existence, who is always seeking us out, always desiring us to come back to him. Whether we've been away from the church, whether we come regularly, the call of the Father is the same. Always to return to him with deep love, always to trust in his goodness. Because the God who comes to us as an infant, the God who makes himself vulnerable to us, the God who's willing to go to the cross for us, well, that's actually the one that we want as our judge. The one who knows what we're worth. The one who knows what we're created for. The one that who knows that he desires us to be like him. And so we place ourselves in the Lord's hands once more this Christmas. We place ourselves in his hands and in the same way that he desires to place himself in ours. Trusting in the Father's love. Trusting in the goodness that he desires for each and every one of us. And maybe this Christmas, just making that resolution in our own hearts to turn back to him once more. I'm going to say, Father, I know where I've been, but even more, I know where you call me. I know that you call me to great goodness, to great heights, and I desire to join you in the heights of heaven. Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
us pray to the Lord. For all others, that they may follow the example of Blessed Mary, who so lovingly welcomed the infant Christ into her life. Let us pray to the Lord. For all gathered here and around the world to celebrate the mystery of Christ's birth, let us pray to the Lord. That members of this assembly visit the sick